Hey, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my entire Poshmark listing process. This is not going to include the sourcing, the prepping, the photographing, or shipping. I will leave videos to those things linked down in the description. Today, all the items are ready to be uploaded. I have the pictures in my phone, and the process I'm going to be walking you through is everything I do from start to finish to get the item up and listed and ready to be sold. Here's what we are going to be discussing: how to edit and upload your pictures to Poshmark, creating your title and a detailed description using pre-made templates to save time, how to track your newly listed inventory in a spreadsheet, and how to quickly cross-post your items to Mercari or Facebook, Etsy, eBay, any other platforms where you wish to sell. And along the way, I'll be sprinkling loads of listing tips. So if you're ready for this information, make sure to give me a thumbs up down below to support this channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more informative videos like this one, and keep on watching. Before we get into step one of this video, I do want to give you a quick disclaimer. When I'm listing on Poshmark, I have several programs open, and I use a combination of my phone and my computer to get my listings done. So there's going to be some back and forth, but I'm going to try to take it slow and explain each step in detail and explain why I do things a certain way. After much experimenting, this is what I have found works for me to effectively get my listings done in a timely manner. In the beginning, it used to take me an hour to list 3 items just on Poshmark, and now I'm listing 5 items within an hour if I'm focused and I have no interruptions, and that's on Poshmark and Mercari. So I've made some progress. We're getting there. I think as soon as I get a faster computer, I can shave off even more time off this listing process. But for now, I'm using what I have, working with what I've got. I really hope that you can gain something from it and that it helps you in some way. First step is going to start on my phone. I take all my pictures on my phone. I used to use a camera, but I found it to be more efficient to have all the photos on my phone and upload them to Poshmark from here, and then I can finish the listing process on my computer later. If I have all the pictures on my phone, I can work from anywhere. When I'm waiting at the dentist, doctors, or anywhere, I can pull out my phone and get some work done. So the first step is going to be to edit a cover photo for each of the items we will be listing. So we're going to be listing these bootcut Lucky Brand jeans, and we're going to be listing these slouch Levi's jeans right here. But I don't edit all of my pictures. I only edit the cover photo, just the photo that you can see in the front. I just make the background white on that, and the rest leave them as is. But even more recently, I stopped editing any photos, not even the cover photo. I will upload the pictures, how they come out, onto Poshmark. And once I'm done with the listing, if I did not find a good stock photo from the internet for my listing, then I will go back and edit the pictures. But I don't take the time to edit the pictures beforehand nowadays. I just upload them as is, go back and fix it later if I don't have a good stock photo after I'm done with the listing process. But for this particular video, we are going to be editing the stock photo just so you can know how the process works. So for these Lucky Brand jeans, the stock photo that I'm going to use is this one where it shows the jeans full length and you can see the entire item right on one picture. Then we're going to click on the share button below the jeans. I am using an Android Galaxy Note 10, I think this is, phone, so some of the functions may be on a different place on your particular phone, but I think overall most phones can do the same thing, so I think that you can figure it out. So clicking on that share button, it's going to bring up all of the apps that I have on my phone, and one of them is this remove.bg app. So if you don't have it, first you must download it from your app store, or you can go to their website. You can drag and drop your photos there to edit them. But clicking on that remove.bg app, that will send this Lucky Brand jeans over to the app and automatically remove the background. There is a download button right below the jeans, but if we download it just as is right now, the background will be transparent. And that's not what I want. I want a white background, so I'm going to click on the edit with the paintbrush off to the right. And as you can see, they have many backgrounds for you to use here, some fancy ones, but I like to just keep everything very clean and just make a white background. And then we can click the arrow that is going down here at the top right to download this Lucky Brand jeans. So that is how I would edit my pictures. And for the Levi's, I'm going to skip the editing and upload my pictures as is and hope that I can find a stock photo. On my home screen, I have the apps that I use the most when I'm listing. That's my three platforms and this Google Docs right here. Clicking on the Poshmark app, we're going to tap on the camera where it says sale towards the bottom. And then we're going to click this photo icon that's off to the bottom left. And that will bring up our camera roll and our different folders of pictures we have on our phone. For the one that we edited, first we're going to upload that one by itself and tap on it, click next, and that will upload it to Poshmark. The very first step is to crop your photos. So for this one, you can tap and hold with two fingers and stretch it out until you like the way it looks on this square, and you can tap with one finger to move it around. But when I'm taking pictures, I make sure that I have my camera on square mode because that's what Poshmark accepts. As you can see, this is squared, and I try to center it so I don't need to crop it later. So most of the time I skip this part by just clicking next. And here, the next step is to edit the photo using one of their filters. The first one is original, then we have rich, so you see it makes it darker. Chrome makes it a little bit more clearer, brighter. And as we keep scrolling down, I think all of the rest you shouldn't use because it distorts your item too much. You don't want your edited item to end up looking different than what it actually is in real life because that can cause returns and miscommunications, many problems down the road. So most of the time I either keep it original, I will make it rich if it doesn't change the item too much, or I'll brighten it up with the chrome. But you can also click on the adjust at the bottom here and edit it on your own by increasing the brightness or decreasing it, the contrast, the vibrance, sharpness. For now, I'm just going to leave it as chrome and click next. Now that my cover photo is edited and uploaded, we're going to go back and grab the rest of the picture. So clicking on that camera icon, the bottom picture icon on the left, and going to camera, and I'm going to upload all of the pictures that go along with this Lucky Brand jeans. And I'm even selecting the one that I used as my cover photo. So again, back to the same steps. The first step is to crop your pictures. But as I said, I crop them as I'm taking the picture, so clicking next. And now my pictures are uploaded to Poshmark. The next step would be to build out a rough draft of my description. To do that, I'm going to go to my home screen, click on Google Docs, click on Posh Descriptions, and here is where I have all of my description templates that I use on a daily basis. So as you can see here, I have at the very top the category that it is, then I have details, I have the condition, and I have a little bit of information about me, that I'm a fast shipping top seller, I accept offers, and just thank the person for stopping by. Where it says details, I would just go in and change that to fit the particular item I am uploading at the time. So as I keep scrolling here, you'll see the many templates that I have for different categories. So here we are on jeans. I'm going to click and highlight this template and then click copy. And now I can go back to my Poshmark listing. Where it says describe it, I will tap and it will say paste, and there is my description. Now I can click the back button, and that is going to bring up a prompt if I want to discard these changes or if I want to save this as a draft. So that is what I'm going to select, save as draft. And that's it. My item, along with the edited picture and the description, is uploaded to Poshmark. And later on, we'll go onto the computer to finish it off. But first, let's do one more item. So clicking on the camera sale icon here, clicking on this picture icon. And this time, instead of going to the remove.bg folder, I'm just going to go to the camera folder, because for the next one, I didn't edit anything. So I can find all the pictures here on camera. And it's going to be these Levi's jeans. So I'm going to select all the pictures that go along with it. And at the top, you see here, it says 14 of 16. You have 16 photos to upload on Poshmark. Very rarely do I use all of them, but I do have 14. So when I'm done selecting those, just clicking next. And again, the first step is to crop your photos. So do that if you need to, and then click next. And then we have to select our cover shot. And for me, that's going to be this shot of the jeans that show the full length. And then we're going to edit it if we need to and click next again. And then I can click where it says describe it. And I don't need to go back to my Google Docs because the template is already copied. I just have to paste it again. And most of the time when I'm listing on Poshmark, I'm listing in categories. So I'm listing all of my jeans, then all of my shoes and all of my sweaters. So when I'm doing this listing process and doing the rough drafts on my phone, it's easy. I just gotta keep pasting the template. I don't have to keep going back to the Google Doc, searching for a different template every time. When all that is done, we're going to click back and click Save as Draft. And that is it for the phone for now. Now we're here on my computer, and here are the three tabs that I have open when I'm listing. We have List Perfectly, My Inventory Spreadsheet, and of course, Poshmark. I'll explain these two when we get to them, but for now, here on Poshmark, we're going to click on Sale on Poshmark. And here are all the drafts that I have uploaded. I did all of these from my phone. And now I can just go on and select it to finish it off here on my computer. Let's go with these Lucky Brand jeans that we did first. Before moving any further, the first thing I want to do is organize my photos because they're kind of scattered and I want them to make sense. The first photo is going to be the front of the jean. So this is the one that I edited and this is the one that is not edited. I like to have both just so people can see what the item actually looks like in its raw form with no edit. From there, it's going to be the bottom of the jean, the top, the back close-up, color close-up, and then we have the measurement, and then we have the tag. Another thing very important to keep in mind is that Mercari only accepts 12 photos. So your Mercari photos are going to stop here. So for me, it's important to keep the pictures that have important information before this point, where it will essentially be the Mercari cutoff point. So I do want this label to be visible on Mercari, so I'm going to move this one that's not that important so that I can move this one here. This is not that important, and all of these can stay here just on Poshmark. Now that the pictures are sorted, the next step is going to be to craft out our title. And for this, we're going to go to the reseller spreadsheet. So first, let me tell you a little bit about this spreadsheet. I used to dream of learning how to use Google Sheets or Excel to create something like this. So I was so excited when I heard Mogi Beth saying that she was going to be selling this. All you have to do is go to her website, pay the $20 or $25. You can download it and input your own information here. They even have many videos that walk you through the whole process and they show you exactly how to use this to manage your business. I will leave the link for this in the description below. But down here we have all our 12 months of the year. Then we have returns. If I click on this arrow, you see right here we also have a stats page. Right now we are only in January, so these are my stats for January. But as we move on through the year, you'll be able to see your stats for each month at a glance. The stats you can see are your sales, your earnings, your profits, your inventory, your margins, your sell-through rate. So much important information here. Next to that is inventory, and this is where all your items that you have listed for sale on different platforms, this is where you can find them. And once an item sells, you're just going to select it and paste it on the month that it sold. And then the last page where it says not posted, this page did not come with Mogi's spreadsheet. I added this page on my own. And I did this because when I come home from the thrift store and unload all of my items, I take off the tag and I want to know exactly what I paid for each item.
So that's why I input the information here. For example, these Levi's, I went ahead and added a title to it, Levi's 720 High Rise, and the size and how much I paid for it. So this spreadsheet was filled out a lot more, but throughout the week I have been posting on Poshmark, so these are the only items I have left to post this week. The ones we are posting now are Lucky Brand Sofia Boot Whitewash. And if I click Control on my keyboard, which by the way, the shortcuts that I'm going to be talking about moving forward will most likely be different on a Mac computer, but you can just look up the shortcuts on Google. But I'm clicking and holding Control on my keyboard and then clicking on the price, and then I can click Control and X, and that's going to cut this information out of the spreadsheet. And now I can go paste it anywhere I want. The first place I'm going to paste it is in my inventory spreadsheet. Where it says item name, I'm going to click on the next empty space, which is right here, and click Control V on my keyboard. And I will paste this item and the price here on my inventory spreadsheet. Now I can go back to Poshmark and click on the title and again Control V to paste that title in here. Now, of course, I'm going to delete the price because I don't want that on my title, but now my title is done. Sometimes it will be completely filled out. Sometimes I will have a little bit of characters left to add a little bit more keywords. So that's what I will do now. And now I'm going to paste the title again in my description by clicking Control V. And from here, we're going to be reworking this title so that it's a little bit different from the top. And we're going to be working on editing this details portion so that it makes sense for these particular jeans. And I like to use my phone and look at the pictures as I'm listing because that triggers keywords in my mind as I'm looking through the pictures and I can zoom in to see details. And to me, it's much easier to do it that way than to look at the pictures here that I've uploaded already to Poshmark, because you'd have to click in each one and try to zoom in that way. I find it easier to do it on my phone, and it's right beside me anyway, so why not? First, I'm going to change the size, and these are casual jeans, but they are not ripped. I'm going to delete that portion of this description. And they are medium wash with whiskering, but they are not skinny. They are boot cut. They do have 5 pockets with belt loops and a zipper closure, so I'm going to leave all of that as is. Now I'm just going to be looking through my pictures to see what else I can say about this item and possibly what other keywords I can add. Looking at my pictures, I just realized that Sofia is spelled S-O-F-I-A. They are cotton and spandex. And these jeans also have a style number, so I'm going to input that here. I'm going to just add light in front of medium because they are light to medium wash, I'd say. So my description is essentially done, and this is what it looks like. At the top, we have a detailed title with as many words that people could possibly be using to find a jean like this. Below, I have the title reinstated to add even more keywords. In this particular case, there's not that many. This is a short title compared to others that I do, but these jeans are pretty simple. Then we have details listed out in a paragraph. I used to do bullet points for my details as I was describing my items, but I heard someone say that in PoshFest, the convention that they have for poshers to give us information on how to be better sellers and things like that, they disclose that Google likes it when your descriptions are in paragraphs as opposed to spaced out in different lines with bullet points, emojis, and all that extra jazz. So since then, I've been keeping my descriptions pretty simple, pretty clean, decluttered, just a paragraph with the details of the item. Below that, I talk about the condition of the item. If it's new with tags, gently used. If it has a flaw, I will definitely delete this that says no flaws and input the flaw and encourage people to go see the pictures. And then below, I have a short little statement about who I am and what they can expect. So that is my description done. The last thing I would do is go to Google and paste this title again to see if I can find a stock photo and to look at other listings to see if I missed any important keywords that I could possibly add to this description. In the past, I would do the research first and build out my description that way. but I felt like it was taking me too long. So after a while, I started becoming more well-versed on what different keywords I could use for my item. So I built out my listing first and then do the Google search. So I clicked Control V to paste the exact same title that I've been having since the reseller spreadsheet. I'm going to delete the size and the price. I'm going to go back to my Poshmark listing and copy the style that I found on the tag from my picture. So I'm going to copy that along with the other title and click enter. So again, I have the pictures next to me here on my phone. So as I look at these different pictures that come up, I can look at my picture and reference it to see if what I'm looking at is the exact same thing I have that I'm listing. So these look pretty similar. I'm going to right click on this and click open link in new tab. So some of the listings here are from the product website and some of them will be from Poshmark, Mercari, and other places. If the product's exact website is available, that's the one I will use to get my stock photo and information, just because their information is detailed most of the time as opposed to other resellers. You can also click here on images to have a better view of things. Here's another Poshmark listing, right clicking, and I'm going to click on open in new tab. This one has different stock photos, so open link in new tab. So here's a Poshmark listing, and while I'm here I will also see when it was last updated, just so I can get a sense of what's my competition doing. Other people who are selling the exact item as me, they say the original price is 98, they're listing it as 38, it has one like, and she updated almost 2 weeks ago. That is that, and as far as keywords, she doesn't have anything here that I could possibly use in my description. Moving on to the next one, these don't seem like mine, they're a little bit darker, and again she doesn't have much in her description either, and she updated hers 6 hours ago. And last one here, she updated 4 days ago. She has it original as 120, she's selling it for 40 or 39, and she has a lot going on in her description. I'm gonna copy this curvy fit and I'm going to download this stock photo to use on my description. So right click on here, click save image as, and click on save, and that will automatically download the picture to the bottom left here on my computer. And now going back to my description, I can paste the keyword curvy fit and I'll put it here right before jeans, and I can drag and drop this cover photo to replace mine that I have here. So I can just click, hold my mouse, and drop it here. Now the problem is that if you drop it when add photo is highlighted but not the whole square like this, it's going to kick you out of this listing and delete everything you have so far. So make sure that you hold on to your mouse and don't release the button on your mouse until the whole square is highlighted like this. Once that's the case, you can let go and it should upload it right here. And now I can click and hold it and drag it and drop it as my cover photo. And this old cover photo, I'm going to move till the end just so that it doesn't mess with what I have going on here. And I want these to stay in this order. And that is pretty much it. From here, the rest is easy peasy. We're going to select our category, which is women's and jeans. These are bootcut jeans. They are size 6 and they are not new with tags. They are Lucky Brand jeans. The color is blue. I'm going to say the original price is 99, which is the lowest price of these three that we were referencing. And for my price, I'm going to go to my phone and see if I have sold other bootcut Lucky Brand jeans to see how much I sold them for, to kind of give me an idea of what I should list these at. I'm going to list mine for 38 and then scroll down. The last thing we'll do on additional details, click on show details, and I'm going to input my cost price right here. That way, when I'm making sales on my phone, sending out offers, doing closet clear out, I can see how much I paid for these jeans right on my phone. I don't have to leave the Poshmark app. This information will be available for me here. So going back to my reseller spreadsheet, I paid $750 for these jeans. But when you put the cost price here on Poshmark, it will not let you use periods. So most of the time I just round up. Instead of putting $750, I just put $8 and click update. Click list this item, and that is our first item listed. From there, I'll just X out all of these tabs that I don't need anymore. Go back to my reseller spreadsheet, update this information, put in the date that I listed this item, which is today, and then go over to the pricing and input 38. Go back to not post it and look for the next item I will be working on, which are these Levi's 504 slouch straight jeans. So tap on that, control on my keyboard to select the price as well, control X to cut this out of here so that I can paste it in my inventory spreadsheet, control V to paste, going back to Poshmark, sell on Poshmark, selecting these jeans. First thing is to arrange these photos in a way that makes sense. Again, if you're going to be cross-posting, make sure that your first 12 photos have all the information that's important for buyers to know. And then we're going to the title, control V to post my title that I copied from my spreadsheet. I'm going to delete the price. And I'm going to speed up the next part, but remember, it is just going to be reworking this title to finish using the rest of the 15 characters I have. I'm going to add a secondary title here. I'm going to be looking at the pictures on my phone so that I can fill out this description. I'm going to make sure that this condition portion is correct. And then from there, I will come back. So referencing my photos, this is the description that I was able to get. Now we're going to go to Google and paste our title to see what we can find. And again here, I'll just be clicking on some of the things that pop up that I feel look like the item I have, so I can see what other people are saying about this item and to kind of get a gist of what other people are listing theirs as. First one we come to here, she updated 4 days ago. She has it at 60 original, 45 listed. Hers are a little bit more used, although in the description she says it's intentional. And on this Mercari tab, I see that some people are calling them vintage. That's when I'm not sure if mines are vintage, but they look like different and older style. I will input inside the description the word retro. It's not vintage, but it's old looking. And that's what the word retro encompasses for me at least. I'm going to delete the ripped and put retro jeans. Sometimes, but not all the time, Amazon descriptions are very detailed because they know the importance of having rich keywords in your titles and descriptions. But after looking at this, I didn't find anything other than the word tilted. If you look at these jeans, you will see that they are sort of, you know, kind of like curved. I noticed that, but I didn't know what to call that. So now we have a name for that. So I am going to delete the word denim here and change it out for tilted. And then here I can add the word denim. So basically what I'm doing here is trying to add as many keywords as I can to my titles and descriptions, but making it sound natural and for it to flow together the best that it can, and trying not to just have a lot of keywords listed and jumbled up together. But moving along, this item is not new with tags. It is Levi's and it is blue. The price, I don't know. I'm going to go with $32. No, let's make it $34. And what I paid for them is $3, so I'm adding that to the cost price on additional details and updating this. List the item. So as you saw for this one, I did not edit the cover photo because, as I stated earlier, I've been uploading my photos as is, and I will go back and edit the cover photo if I didn't find a stock photo to use. So for this one, I didn't. So I'm going to right click and click on Save Image As, click Save, and now the image will be downloaded here. And then if we go to the remove.bg website, I can click and hold, drag and drop my image, click on edit, it works just like the phone version, tap on color, click the white one, and download. Download again. Now the picture will be here at the bottom. Now I can go back to Poshmark, edit this, Now I can upload my new cover photo with the white background, and I can tap and hold and drag it so that it is now my cover photo. As you see, this is my original. It's still pretty bright, it's still good, but I just feel like with the white background, the item pops a little more.
So now that our item is completely listed on Poshmark, our next step is to cross-post it to Mercari or any other platform where you wish to list it. And here is what my setup station for that looks like. I have my computer here on this little black table with my scale next to it, a notepad and a pen to write down weights when needed. I have these poly bags here. I have three different size poly bags. I showed you what these look like in my shipping video that I will link down below. And here is the basket. After I'm done taking pictures, I fold the items neatly and I leave them in this basket. Then I will take it out of this basket. I will cross post it over to Mercari on my computer. I will weigh the item because Mercari uses weight. And once that is posted over to Mercari, I will take the appropriate poly bag, add the item to the poly bag, and then store the item. To cross post, I use this program called List Perfectly. I've been using it for a while and I really enjoy it. It just makes the process easy and fast. Right now I'm using this simple plan that is $29 a month, but even with this simple plan I am not using all the features that they have available here. I'm just using the very first one, which is the cross posting. In the future I do intend to make better use of List Perfectly and incorporate more of what it has to offer into my listing process, but for now I'm keeping things simple and just using the cross posting feature. If you want to try it out for yourself, I'll leave the link down in the description, and you can always use my code THEMOMBOSS for 30% off your first month. Once you have an account and you're logged in, this is what the home screen looks like. I'll leave a complete tutorial for later on in the future. For now, just want to explain that there are two different ways to go about using List Perfectly to cross-post your items. The first way is to come here and click on Add Product. Here you can add your photos, you can create templates, make your descriptions, and post them here on List Perfectly. And here's where your items will live. This is where they will permanently be. And from there, you can cross post to other platforms. You can even delist from here. You can keep track of analytics and all sorts of things. But another way to go about it is to log on to one of your platforms. I'm here on Poshmark. And if you're logged in to List Perfectly, you'll always have this blue List Perfectly logo thingy going on at the top of each of your listings. And this is the way that I use it right now. So we're going to go ahead and click on this blue button to show you how it works. You can select all and it'll select all these platforms for you, or you can go on to click the ones that you want to cross post. Right now I'm just going to cross post to Mercari, so I'll select that one and click copy. It'll start opening new tabs for you and moving all of your pictures along with your title and your description. Sometimes it takes a while. And while that's working, I will make sure to weigh my item and package it so that I have that ready to input the weight on the Mercari description. I do have an entire Mercari tutorial, so I'm not going to go too in-depth with this whole Mercari listing process. I'm just going to go through and point out some important things. The first is to notice that here on Mercari, they only allow 12 photos, so make sure that your sizing, your measurements, your close-ups, and all of that are in the right place, so when you cross-post, nothing important gets cut off. Second is that here on Mercari, they only allow 40 characters for your title. Poshmark allows 50, so your title will be cut off, so it is going to be necessary for you to rework it so that it makes sense. So for this one, for example, I'd probably highlight light wash, control X to cut it out of the description, and then go ahead and put something else here to take its place. And then I can just paste this light wash part down here so that I'm not losing any of my keywords. And then scrolling down, you'll have to add your tags here. Because of your description, Mercari sort of knows what you're trying to sell, so they'll give you some suggested categories, and most of the time they will have the one that your product actually is. So mine's are jeans and bootcut, so selecting that. They'll also suggest a brand for you because of the information that's already in your description. And you'll just select your condition, your color, your size.
I think depending on which list perfectly plan you have, some of these may already be filled out. The higher your plan, the more of this information will be pre-filled already. And then here where it says the shipping is where you'll need to input your weight, so make sure you weigh all your items. Once everything's filled out, you just click list and your item is ready to go. Then you'd go back to Poshmark and move on to the next item.
Since you made it to the end of this video, I want to give you two bonus tips that have helped me make this whole Poshmark reselling journey a little bit less overwhelming. The number one thing is to let go of perfectionism. It used to take me forever to take pictures, make my descriptions, my titles, and all of that because I was so inclined on making things just perfect. Learn that good enough is good enough. You can always go back and edit your listings, add new photos, change around the description. The important thing is to get it listed, get it out there. You have more chances of making sales if you upload 10 imperfect listings than if you upload 3 listings that are perfect and great lighting and everything is on point. So let go of perfectionism. You'll get a lot more done and you'll make progress a lot faster. The second thing is to take it slow. It may take you an hour to do 3 listings in the beginning because you're just learning. But as you become more well-versed on how these applications work, Poshmark, Mercari, you'll be a lot faster of just clicking buttons and zooming through listings. And you'll learn a lot more keywords, ways to describe things, so you'll take a lot less time. But in the beginning, be okay with it taking a little bit more time than it should. Just time yourself, turn on your timer every time you start listing. Look at your times often and continue to refine your process and come up with better and new ways to take less time doing these things. I really hope this video helped you. If it did, make sure to let me know in the comments. And if you have any tips to help us be more effective Poshmark sellers, make sure to let us know those in the comments below. And that's all for me today. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you next time.